church, but the whole community is here. Could you take one moment, find three people in the room who you don't know. Find three people whose names you don't know. Would you go very quickly? I am embracing and tell them something good is going to happen for us.
How you doing, Jerry?
Let car going. I know you let car going, don't you?
Invite your followers, invite them. Let them hear this word.
myself.
There's anybody who has a deep abiding love for our Lord and Savior.
Yes.
I feel almost like Moses at the burning bush, but I need to turn my shoes off.
Come on.
Standing in the hollow steps of Dr. E. Edward Jones, a gospel globetrotter and apostolic ambassador, and I'm spokesman for the Baptists. We're appreciative for his life, for his witness, and for his legacy. I underscore that because black people have a strange proclivity to only celebrate our leaders after they're gone.
That's mercy.
Our leaders are with us. We run their names through the street.
Mercy.
And after they're gone, we name the street after them.
Mercy. Already.
All right.
lift every voice and sing. What do you say?
Mercy.
Sing a song full of the faith that the dark past
has
taught us.
Mercy.
Not sing Little Wayne. Not sing the future. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought us.
Yes.
Not late night playing.
Talk so.
Facing the rising sun of our new day begun, let us march on until victory is won. It's apparent that the song Shreveport has been lost on a generation that has laryngitis.
Wow.
Because everyone hasn't complied to lift their voice. Our collective voice is silent about none of the presidential candidates saying a word about reparations.
Come on here.
Become silent almost where it feels like sign language should be instituted, because we've said nothing about the governor of Michigan knowingly contaminating 900,000 residents with water he wouldn't drink.
Mercy.
We're silent about the governor of Maryland building $480 million jail.
Wow.
But taking that money away from Morgan State and Cotton State College. We're silent that in California they have built 22 new prisons in 20 years and not opened one college.
Mercy.
We're silent that right here in Louisiana that garbage collectors make more money than public school teachers. We're silent that 20 miles from Dallas they don't even have an operable sewage system. We're silent about Will and Jada dressing their son up like a girl.
Wow.
I'm sorry. And what made it was James Weldon. They said lift up your voice. The only thing worse than the oppressed not finding their octave is when God goes silent.
Mercy.
In Ecclesiastes it states that there is a time to be silent.
Yes, sir.
And as a consequence, the author must have been riveted when reading the 8th chapter of Revelations. Where it is revealed that after the 7th seal is opened, there is silence in heaven for 30 minutes. For the first 6 seals, the 144,000 are sworn in, and the Jehovah Witnesses are validated.
Mercy.
When the 2nd seal is open, the elders line up for the procession. And the 5th seal is open, the Pentecostals find celebration because angels start swinging. The music ministry finds that they are, in fact, mentioned honorably with string instruments and organs. However, when this 7th seal is open, all of a sudden heaven goes silent. And I'm not sure whether or not we need hearing aids.
All right.
But I am afraid maybe heaven is silent. And I'm listening to the Afro-hermeneutic of contemporary black preaching. Is any indication God must not be talking. Because we've not heard from black prophetic witness. And all we're hearing about is everybody being a millionaire. Everybody being debt free.
Help us.
Everybody driving a Benz.
Help us.
But we never hear anything about a lost word your grandmother used to use called long suffering.
My.
If you suffer with him, then you'll reign with him. There's no prophetic gospel because so many of us are auditioning for the preachers of our life. We've got preachers now wearing Rolex, but they don't know what time it is. Silence is expectant. Silence is eager. Silence is an act of faith. Silence means we are ready to hear what the Lord's about to say. Silence is the prerequisite to hearing. And hearing is from the Word of God. When we fall silent in the presence of the Lord, it is an audible prostration. And maybe a lot of us are not getting our prayers answered because the deacons only gave us half the lesson. They told us how to talk to God, but never told us how to listen.
Wow.
So we pray and jump into faith. We pray when we're in crisis.
Wow.
But don't hear doves cry. We pray when it is that there's emergency intervention. And all the while, God keeps trying to get our attention. Long before Southwest Airlines and frequent flyer miles, while your family was still taking road trips, your parents instituted the quiet game. Let's see how long you can be quiet. Only for you to be interrupted to say, are we there yet?
Wow.
And God's been trying to take Shreveport somewhere, but you keep interrupting.
Talk.
He's trying to give you the blueprint, but you want to talk over him. Such was the case of some black crows that found themselves under a net. And then when they were in fact found under a net, they were trying to come up much like black Shreveport with a strategy. How are we going to get out of this?
Yeah.
And these black crows said, on the count of three, let's all flap our wings.
All right.
And if we flap our wings at the same time, we'll fly out of it. They counted. On the count of three, we're going to all flap our wings, and then we'll be able to break the net. They counted one, two, and then some crows said, when we get out of it, who's going to speak at the press conference? So let's try it again. One, two. Another crow interrupted and said, when we get out of this, who are we going to say the idea came from?
Sounds
like black
crows. Sound like black crows. Yes, sir.
Said, on the count of three, if we clap our wings at the same time.
Stop.
One, two. Before we do it, I want to know who's the president of this alliance.
Stop.
Invite your followers.
Help us!
Clap our wings at the same time. We don't have to ask anybody here. Jesus often referenced his appointed time. And when he spoke of his appointed time, he was referencing his crucifixion. So when there is a pause for half an hour, it is to indicate that the time of his agony and suffering had been cut in half.
All right.
This, in fact, causes a problem for neo-Pentecostals who are in this place, who parade and trumpet as a catchphrase, it's your time.
All right.
And we immediately, instinctively, automatically go into celebratory shouting. But when God said it's your time, it is not time for victory, it's time for agony. And I don't know what has happened to black people where we believe that there's no more agony. Oh, you thought we'd arrive because we got a black president and still wouldn't have black issues.
Wow.
The last 7 years of white malicious supremacist groups have, in fact, multiplied by 300%. Already on this B8 March the 4th, you ought to know that there have been 651 sightings of police shooting unarmed black men while you have a black president.
Wow.
Last year, 2,371 black churches foreclosed because of predatory lending while you have a black president. It's hard for you to protest.
follow me. We're going to try to interview him at the church. Yeah. Make sure you follow. Hit that follow button and follow me now. If you're not, if you're first time, see if we can catch up with him. Make sure you follow. Make sure you follow. Y'all have a good night. If y'all didn't shout, it's y'all problem. See y'all.
Yeah. Bye, mama.
Yes, sir.
Because it's not just one church, but the whole community is here. Could you take one moment, find three people in the room who you don't know. Find three people whose names you don't know. Would you go very quickly? I don't embrace it and tell them something is going to happen for us.
How you doing, sir? Lincoln, I know you're Lincoln, though.
Stop.
The only thing worse than the oppressed not finding their octave is when God goes silent.
Mm.
Verse 10.
In Ecclesiastes, it states that there is a time to be silent.
Yes, sir.
And as a consequence, the author must have been riveted when reading the 8th chapter of Revelations, where it is revealed that after the 7th seal is opened, there was silence in heaven for 30 minutes.
Yeah.
For the first 6 seals, the 144,000 are sworn in, and the Jehovah Witnesses are validated. When the 2nd seal is open, the elders line up for the procession. And the 5th seal is open, the Pentecostals find celebration because angels start swinging. The music ministry finds that they are, in fact, mentioned honorably with string instruments and organs. However, being that this 7th seal is open, all of a sudden heaven goes silent. And I'm not sure whether or not we need hearing aids.
All right.
But I am afraid maybe heaven is silent.
Yeah.
And of listening to the Afro-hermeneutic of contemporary black preaching is any indication God must not be talking, because we've not heard from black prophetic witness. And all we're hearing about is everybody's being a millionaire. Everybody being debt free.
Help us.
Everybody driving a pen.
Help us.
But we never hear anything about a lost word your grandmother used to use called long suffering.
Yeah.
If you suffer with him, then you're running. There's no prophetic gospel because so many of us are auditioning for the preachers of LA. We've got preachers now wearing Rolex, but they don't know what time it is. Heaven must be silent. I might suggest to you tonight that silence is not passive. Silence is expectant. Silence is eager. Silence is an act of faith. Silence means we are ready to hear what the Lord's about to say. Silence is the prerequisite to hearing. And hearing is from the Word of God. When we fall silent in the presence of the Lord, it is an audible prostration. And maybe a lot of us are not getting our prayers answered because the deacons only gave us half the lesson. They told us how to talk to God, but never told us how to listen.
Wow.
So we pray and jump into faith. We pray when we're in crisis.
Wow.
But don't hear doves cry. We pray when it is that there's emergency intervention. And all the while, God keeps trying to get our attention. Long before Southwest Airlines and frequent flyer miles, while your family was still taking road trips, your parents instituted the quiet game. Let's see how long you can be quiet. Only for you to be interrupted to say, are we there yet?
Wow.
And God's been trying to take Shreveport somewhere, but you keep interrupting.
Talk.
He's trying to give you the blueprint, but you want to talk over him. Such was the case of some black crows that found themselves under a net. And then when they were in prison, I'm elated, humbled, and honored for this committee allowing me this opportunity to be able to share for Black Shreveport. If you have your Bibles, I'd love to issue a warrant for your intelligent rest and send you to the book of Ecclesiastes. Ecclesiastes chapter 3.
All right.
Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 7. And I want to illuminate for your understanding clause B. There's a time to be silent.
Wow, what you say.
Okay.
For the time that is mine, I want to use as a subject, lift every voice.
Oh, right now.
James Weldon Johnson pointed blank penned the National Negro Anthem. And it actually originated as a poem performed by 500 primary school students in celebration of the life of Abraham Lincoln. The NAACP co-opted it as its official song in 1900. The lyrics gave language to people's resilience and resolve in spite of inequitable treatment. The opening lines are not meant as a suggestion, but as a demand.
All right.
Lift every voice and sing. What do you say?
Mercy.
Sing a song full of the faith that the dark past
say it.
Has taught us.
Mercy.
Not sing Little Wayne. Not sing the future. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought us.
Yes.
Not late night blame.
Talk to him.
Facing the rising sun of our new day begun, let us march on until victory is won. It's apparent that the song Shreveport has been lost on a generation that has laryngitis.
Wow.
Because everyone hasn't complied to lift their voice. Our collective voice is silent about none of the presidential candidates saying a word about reparations.
Come on here.
Become silent almost where it feels like sign language should be instituted, because we've said nothing about the governor of Michigan knowingly contaminating 900,000 residents with water he wouldn't drink.
Mercy.
We're silent about the governor of Maryland building $480 million jail.
Wow.
But taking that money away from Morgan State and Cotton State College. We're silent that in California they have built 22 new prisons in 20 years and not opened one college.
Mercy.
We're silent that right here in Louisiana, that garbage collectors make more money than public school teachers. We're silent that 20 miles from Dallas, they don't even have an operable sewage system. We're silent about Will and Jada dressing their son up like a girl.
Wow.
I'm sorry. In fact, found under the net, they were trying to come up much like Black Shreveport with a strategy. How are we going to get out of this? And these black crows said, on the count of three, let's all flap our wings.
All right.
And if we flap our wings at the same time, we'll fly out of it. They counted. On the count of three, we're going to all flap our wings, and then we'll be able to break the net. They counted one, two, and then some crow said, when we get out of it, who's going to speak at the press conference? So let's try it again. One, two. Another crow interrupted and said, when we get out of this, who are we going to say the idea came from?
Sounds like black crow.
Yes, sir. Said, on the count of three, if we flap our wings at the same time. One, two. Before we do it, I want to know who's the president of this alliance.
Invite your followers.
Jesus often referenced his appointed time. And when he spoke of his appointed time, he was referencing his crucifixion. So when there is a pause for half an hour, it is to indicate that the time of his agony and suffering had been cut in half.
All right.
This, in fact, causes a problem for neo-Pentecostals who are in this place, who parade and trumpet as a catchphrase, "It's your time."
All right.
And we immediately, instinctively, automatically go into celebratory shouting. But when God said it's your time, it is not time for victory, it's time for agony. Woo. And I don't know what has happened to black people where we believe that there's no more agony. Oh, you thought we'd arrive because we got a black president and still wouldn't have black issues.
Wow.
The last 7 years of white malicious supremacist groups have, in fact, multiplied by 300%. Already on this B8 March the 4th, you all know that there have been 651 sightings of police shooting unarmed black men while we have a black president.
Wow.
Last year, 2,371 black churches foreclosed because of predatory lending. Wow, you have a black president. Yeah. It's hard for you to protest.
Invite those followers. Invite the followers, invite them. Let them hear this word.
This is my who has a deep abiding love for our Lord and Savior.
Yes!
Thank you, glory. I feel almost like Moses at the burning bush, but I need to turn my shoes off.
Come on.
Standing in the hollow steps of Dr. E. Edward Jones, a gospel globetrotter and apostolic ambassador. And I'm spokesman for the Baptists. We're appreciative for his life, for his witness, and for his legacy.
Yeah.
I underscore that because black people have a strange proclivity to only celebrate our leaders after they're gone.
That's mercy.
And our leaders are with us. We run their names through the street.
Mercy.
And after they're gone, we name the street after them. about really going service.
Yes, sir.
The unadulterated gospel of Jesus Christ. The reason why it is apropos is because we're living in an hour where shepherds don't like sheep.
Wow.
There are a lot of pastors who have more armor bearers than they have men. Actually loves the people. Never aspired to be a celebrity, but a desire just to be a servant. Wow. Thank God for that. Bears witness in his life as a PK. I'm overwhelmingly appreciative. You all know that 87% of preachers' children over 25 don't go to church.
Right.
87% of preachers' kids past the age of 25 don't go to church. Because so many times the preacher's child has to be the mistress.
Mercy.
The father is in love with the church and just gets to the children in their spare time. Cornel West said it's a terrible thing to be a public success and a private failure. But for his daughter to be able to stand and embracingly loving like salutes her father says what kind of shepherd he is after the benediction. After that, we are truly grateful not just for being a good pastor.